President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urging Filipinos not to back down from challenges that threaten the country's peace. The president led Tuesday's ceremony at the World War II Shrine in Bataan Province. He spoke of clear and present threats to Philippine sovereignty, which he said have inflicted harm on Filipinos. Marcos's remarks come amid growing aggression from China in the West Philippine Sea. The most recent was the shadowing by the Chinese Coast Guard of Filipino vessels near a reef in Palawan over the weekend. Filipino troops also previously injured from water attacks by China.
Ang mga ito ay hindi katanggap-tanggap, hindi makatwiran o makatarungan, lalo na sa panahong ito ng payapang pakikipag-ugnayan ng mga bansa. Tulad ng pinamalas ng ating mga dakilang ninuno, hindi tayo dapat magpasupil at magpaapi, lalo na sa loob ng ating sariling bakuran. Naway, mapagkuna natin ito ng pang-ibayong kamalayan, tapang at lakas ng loob.
Vice President Sara Duterte, meanwhile, called on Filipinos to remember the bravery of those who fought for the country's freedom. Duterte, who is the concurrent education secretary, guaranteed that their sacrifice will be taught to young learners.
Kaisa ako ng sambayan ng Pilipino sa pagbibigay pugay sa kanilang hindi matatawarang sakripisyo para sa kalayaan na ating tinatamasa ngayon. Sila ay natatanging halimbawa ng tapang at pagmamahal sa bayan.
Fisherfolk Group Pamalakaya and other organizations flocked to the Chinese embassy in Manila to protest Chinese aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Pamalakaya's chair, Fernando Hica, clarified earlier statements that cautioned against joint maritime patrols. He says they are urging Manila to formulate an independent foreign policy that does not lean towards the interests of any superpower. Hiccup's clarification comes after the National Security Council accused Pamalakaya of sympathizing with China.
Statement ni National Security Malaya, kami raw ay pro-China. Hindi po, no? At nililinaw natin kay Secretary na ang aming posisyon ay hindi maka-China at hindi maka-US at ayaw namin ng gira. Ang gusto natin ay kapayapaan. Hindi makatarungan at hindi makatao yung ganung posisyon. No?
Progressive group Bayan Muna urges President Marcos to implement a demilitarization policy in the South China Sea. Its chair, Neri Colmenares, warns the joint patrols with the U.S. and Australia could further escalate tensions in the disputed waters. Instead, Colmenares proposes patrols that are civilian in nature with other ASEAN countries with similar maritime disputes with Beijing, such as Vietnam and Indonesia. He says these patrols will aim to stem the flow of human trafficking, drugs, and destruction of the marine environment in the South China Sea. 7 out of 10 Filipinos agreed to the proposal to make the Reserve Officers Training Corps, or ROTC, mandatory for all young people. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri shared this finding in a survey he commissioned with Pulse Asia. The survey was conducted in December of last year. For Senator Ronald De La Rosa, he is hoping for the swift approval of the law to revive the ROTC. He cites the importance of this kind of training for defense preparedness. The senator also gave assurances safeguards will be in place to monitor and prevent possible abuses. Zubiri earlier said that the Senate will prioritize discussions on the bill when session resumes. The bill is currently on second reading in the Senate.